keep on rocking in the free world.
Keep on rocking in the free world.
What's up, ladies and germs?
So, something that always gets asked inevitably in this community is, what about relationships and van life, or, you know, having a girlfriend or having a boyfriend or whatever other 68 different genders you decide to date? And a lot of people ask me this because I've been living this way for pretty much my entire adult life, and I can't tell you how it's different from people that live in apartments or stationary homes, but I can tell you how I see it's pretty much the same. For example, I'm right now parked outside my girlfriend's place, and, you know, I've dated a lot of girls over the years that I would have never met them if it wasn't because of van life, and that's actually a great way to meet women, in my experience. Not only is there a lot of females living in RVs and vans, but there's a lot who really dig the idea and the lifestyle, and I think it all comes down to the whole security thing. Well, first of all, a lot of women are attracted to guys that are different and more adventurous and, you know, not the same old living paycheck to paycheck in a basement suite or an apartment like everyone else, but they're doing something different, and that's exciting for a lot of women. And also, definitely the fact that if you own your motorhome, you literally own your home. You're not at risk of living on the street because you lose your job and you can't make your rent payment. For the most part, something like 80% or 85% of the population lives paycheck to paycheck, so, and most of these people rent, and you're living under someone else's home. And I love it when people like to say, oh, if you live in an RV, you're homeless. I look at it the other way around. We're actually the ones that own our homes. Now, homeowners, of course, that's a whole other story, but most people who rent, who say something like that, they're the ones living in someone else's house. So they don't have a home. They have permission to sleep in someone else's home as long as they pay a whole bunch of money every month. So to me, that's more homeless than this, by a long shot. And I think women see that too, and I've met a lot of women, they've admitted straight up, they like the idea that a guy's, it not necessarily has to be financially secure, just the fact that you actually own your place and you're in control of it, and that is a turn-on for a lot of women. In my experience, living in a van has never been a turn-off for women, and if it was, that's obviously not the type of woman you'd want to date anyways. I love it when guys are like, well, you know, so-and-so, I'd like to date her, but she would never date that lifestyle. Well, then why would you want to date somebody that wouldn't be into how you want to live, or, you know, the things that you like? That doesn't make any sense to me. So, obviously, you're going to attract like-minded people when you do this, and I've met a lot of women over the years, ones that I haven't dated, too, and I've asked that question. I said, well, what would you think about a guy living in his RV? And most of them are like, it makes no difference how they live. It's about the person, and that's what it should be about. But this lifestyle has definitely helped me meet a lot of people over the years, and I've ended up dating a couple that had their own vans, too, and right now I'm dating a girl that, well, it's been a year now. It's our one-year anniversary. She doesn't live in an RV. She loves this RV, but she has her own place, and I go and visit her on my days off, which is what I'm doing now. And sometimes she drives in to visit me and stays with me in the RV. So to me, it's no different than any other type of relationship where one person lives in an apartment, the other person lives in a house or a treehouse or a boat, or it doesn't matter. You go and you visit the other person, you stay at their place. It doesn't matter whether there's wheels under their place or not. A place is a place. So to me, it's completely irrelevant. The question is irrelevant. Well, what about relationships? Will you live in a van? Well, what about relationships? Will you live in a house? What if you find somebody that doesn't like your house? It's the same thing. To me, it's just such a weird question. It's almost like somebody's afraid to live the way they want to live because they're afraid that they're not going to meet somebody that approves of the way they want to live. Well, then that person's not for you. End of discussion. That there's nothing else to say about that. If I'm not going to look at my girlfriend and say, I don't want to date you because you're not living in an RV because you've chosen to live in a townhouse. That's what that sounds like. On the contrary, she has said, oh, I don't know, like 400,000 times that she would love to live this way one day. And you never know, it might be in our future. As it is now, this is great. I can bring my house with me and visit her, stay with her for the weekends, and she comes to visit me. We go off, we can do camping, we go to music festivals, we can do all this stuff and bring the house with us. It can be an advantage too. So I don't see this lifestyle as being any hindrance to dating. If anything, it's helped. In many ways, it's helped. So it's actually been a positive. So I think if you've got problems meeting women, it has nothing to do with whether you live in a van or live in a boat or live in a mansion. It has everything to do with you and maybe your social skills, or maybe you just never get out and do things and meet people. But I don't think that blaming it on the fact your house has wheels underneath it is a fair argument at all. In fact, I think that's just a cop-out. So that's my opinion on that, guys. I'd love to hear your comments below. I know a lot of my viewers have said the same thing that I just told you right now, so I'd love to hear your stories, too, about you and your girlfriend or your boyfriend, or whether you live on wheels or not, or whether you met when you were on wheels. I'd love to hear your stories below, so hit me up. Keep on rocking the free world, everyone.